Bible said that he might bring to us being put to death in the flesh, that you are made alive by the Spirit. 19. What does 19 say? By whom also he went and preached to the spirits in prison. He went there to do a crusade. He preached. He even extended the altar call to those who were in the worst part, those who were tortured, and they didn't mind him. I was preaching some, and I said, there are some people, even if you preach and hold them by the hand and carry them to heaven, they will run away to hell. They will leave heaven and run away to hell. Even Jesus, it's not me. Jesus went to hell to preach to people that were in hell, they didn't mind. And he said, how many of you would like to be born again? Abraham collected all the good people. He said, we will follow you. And then the Bible said, Jesus took them and he held captivity captive and took them along. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you understand what I'm talking about? And from that day on, when a man dies and dies in Christ, you don't go down, you go up. From that day on, you go up to a place reserved. But before that time, everybody goes down. It was only Elijah and one or two people that God called up. Everybody goes up. So Jesus, by his death and his resurrection, opened the door of hell and captivity.
Amen.
I came to tell you this afternoon,
yes,
that in the door of hell and captivity, in the door of prison, in the door holding you captive, holding your peace of mind, holding your joy, holding your marriage, holding your finances, holding your spirituality, shall be broken this morning. In the name of Jesus, that door will open for you. Somebody shout, doors open! That door will open for you. From your family, from the spirit world, from the atmospheric powers that are trying to hold you down, that door shall be destroyed. I said 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 that door shall be destroyed. And the door try to hold you, the power of Jesus breaks that door. So that door was open. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Clap for Jesus for that. And the door. Oh, Jesus is able to open every door. Are you enjoying the preach once more?
Yes.
The fourth door that opened was the door of the sepulchre. You could call it the tomb. You could call it the new grave. You see, when you read Matthew 28, 1 and 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, I think, Matthew 28, the Bible said, after Jesus had entered hell and has dealt with the doors there, and then had resurrected, he now needed to come up and display, show his glory, let everybody know that he was alive. But the people had put a big stone at the mouth of the tomb. So even though he had resurrected, it was going to be impossible for him to come out. And how would we have known that the man had resurrected? And how would he have displayed his glory? And how would he have called the disciples and said, come, I was dead, but now I am alive. Nobody could have seen it. Nobody could have celebrated him. The church would not have been born. We would not have been sitting here celebrating Jesus. Do you understand? Even though he had resurrected, so something was preventing him. It was a door of the sepulchre. And I came to tell you, any door trying to stop your glory from shining, we go fire him. I said we go fire him. Any door trying to prevent your potential. You are a man with potential. You are a woman with substance. There is something in you. There is a certain grace upon your life. But certain doors want to hinder it. We shall destroy this thing. We shall break it this thing. We shall demolish it this thing. In the name of Jesus. By the power of the resurrected Lord. It shall be destroyed. I say 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 it shall be destroyed. Doors open. And the door, I don't care where it's coming from, try to stop you from shining. Try to stop you from becoming unravel. Try to stop you from achieving your dream. That thing must be open.
Yes.
I said that thing must must be. Are you ready to pray?
Yes.
That we must do some mathematics this morning.
Yes.
That is spiritual mathematics.
Hey,
we shall break certain laws. Are you ready to break certain laws?
Yes.
Listen, you came with a destiny.
Mm.
You were born with glory.
Mm.
There is something honorable sitting on your life.
Mm.
But certain circumstances and certain issues want to prevent you. You were born with a beautiful face, smiling one.
Mm.
But over a year now, you have not smiled. You're always looking single. King, can you be hard? Hard like a defender. But the glory of God is coming upon you. That door that is saying, I will not allow you to shine. That door that is saying, I will not allow you to be glorious. That door that is not allowing you to be celebrated. We will defray that door. You will be celebrated. You will be glorified. You will be honored. You will be lifted. People will see what is in you. That door was destroyed. I came to tell you that door too will be destroyed.
Amen.
Are you enjoying my preach?
Yes,
I can preach some small. Praise the Lord. Number five. I'm almost there. The fifth door. I'm just sharing about seven. Oh, it'll be okay. The fifth door that opened by the death and the resurrection of Jesus. Are you okay?
Yes.
Was the door of the New Testament. You see, even at the time Jesus was preaching, it was not New Testament. It was after his death and resurrection that we entered New Testament. So the door of the New Testament then opened. So on the day of the last supper, he lifted up the cup and he lifted up the bread and he said, this is the blood of the new testament, the new covenant. Matthew 26:28. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So the door, so it is by his death and resurrection that he established the new covenant and the new testament. So that door opened. And I see that door to opening for you.
Amen.
That's why you are here. It's already open. But I came to add a little bit to it. That by virtue of that act, oh, new things are coming for somebody.
Amen.
New blessings.
Yes.
New favors.
Amen.
New liftings.
Amen.
New things.
Yes.
Only three people are saying amen. The one with the loudest amen, it is for you.
Amen.
The loudest amen, there is praise. There is praise in heaven.
Amen.
May God open new things.
Amen.
May new doors open.
Amen.
New favors. New job opportunities. Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
New levels in finances.
Amen.
New levels in anointing.
Amen.
New levels in glory.
Amen.
May God open it for you.
Amen.
May God open it for you.
Amen.
How many of you are tired of the old? You are tired of the old. You want something new. How many of you want something new? You want a new blessing. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Ah, there are about three people. You are tired of your old job. You want a new job. It is coming your way. That application will go through. Receive it! New house. I don't know who I'm talking to. Who is that person? You will build it in the name of Jesus. You are tired of that, your family house at Doma. You want to build a new house. The door of new things is opening. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it. May something new begin to happen to you. I said, may something new. You know what new? Pastor, may you receive new members. New levels in everything. Receive it in the name of Jesus. May God begin to make your church new.
Amen.
And there is somebody, even your health, God is renewing it.
Amen.
Oh, I hear that there is somebody who insists that God is making you 40.
Amen.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Satan. You will walk in the strength of a 40-year-old man. You will walk in the strength of a 40-year-old man. Even though you are 60, may God renew it. May something new locate you. Only three people are saying amen.
Amen.
I think you are the one.
Amen.
May something new locate you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You don't understand my preach.
Understand.
Or you understand.
Amen.
Or it's boiling.
Amen.
It's not boiling at all. Number six. So I'm almost done. Sometimes I preach much more. The sixth door that I want to pick up was a door of all nations. Love that one. The door of all nations. That's a good door. The door of all nations. So the day he was crucified, even the king wrote. He wrote, he did a signboard. You know signboard. Signboard. He did a signboard. Some of you don't understand. The king did a signboard and placed it on the head of Jesus. And the Bible said it was written in Greek, Latin, and Hebrew. Luke 23:38. Greek. Luke 23:38. Greek, Hebrew, and Latin. But prior to that, everything about the worship of God was for the Jews. Not for every other person. Even when Jesus was around, he did not send the disciples outside. He said, I'm sending you among the Jews. You understand? People even come to him to pay for a healing, and he said that children's bread must not be given to other people. It must be given to Jews. It was the preserve of Jews. But by his death and his resurrection, the door to all nations opened. Do you understand what I'm talking about? So you come to Revelation chapter 5 and verse 9. Revelation 5 verse 9. And Jesus now presents himself to the Father. And you hear the kings, the elders and all them, they fall down and they start to worship. Revelation 5 9. And they say, by your blood you have redeemed all nations, tribes and tongues. Can you put that on the board? I like it. Revelation chapter 5 verse 9. You have redeemed. So it is the door of all nations open at that point. Are you putting Revelation 5:9? Yeah, I like it. Revelation 5:9. Yeah, yeah. You are worthy to take the scroll and to open the seals, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood out of every tribe and tongue and people and nation.
Hallelujah.
The door of all nations open. That is why you are Ghanaian and you are born again. You are Nigerian, you are born again. You are Cameroonian, you are born again. You are British, you are born again. Everybody can be born again.
Amen.
Because when Jesus came, he did not come to England. He did not go to New York. He only hung around. But the day he died and resurrected, the door to all nations opened. I was talking with your pastor. And he said, you are trying to do a church in Pakistan, trying to do a church in Italy, and I was happy.
Yes.
That's a door of our nation.
Yes.
And all of you must support it.
Amen.
You must not only be conscious about your native people. You must not only be concerned about blacks. There are whites in this town, that must be saved.
Amen.
There are people of other nationalities, that must be saved.
Amen.
Let us pray for them.
Amen.
Let us look out for them.
Amen.
Let us witness to them.
Amen.
Even if they insult us, it doesn't matter.
Amen.
And our church must be ready to embrace all colors.
Amen.
Do you understand what I'm talking about?
Yes.
People from other nationalities must not feel intimidated when they come to church. They must not feel left out when they come to church. The door of all nations open.
Amen.
We must be ready to take the gospel everywhere. We must sponsor it. We must push in our resources. Because the door of all nations is open. And as I conclude on that, I want you to also know that by that act, the door of all nations, financially, materially, economically, everything is open.
Amen.
If people are succeeding here, you must succeed some. If you don't succeed, it's a mistake. Do you understand? White people must succeed. Black people must succeed. Green people must succeed. Everybody must succeed. Once you have come to me at the case, the door of this nation and this town is open for you.
Amen.
I see you building. Amen. I see you buying.
Yeah.
If they drive a car, drive some.
Amen.
If they build some.
Yeah.
If they buy some.
Yeah.
If they do some. Whatever they have, you must have some.
Yeah.
It is not for some people.
Yeah.
Don't demean yourself.
Yeah.
Don't put yourself down. Don't make yourself inferior.
Yeah.
I know this place is sad. You can make it though. You can make it.
Yeah.
Give somebody a high five and say you can make it.
Yeah.
Tell him the door of all nations is open. If they wear the best, you must eat the best. If they try the best, you can try the best. If they enjoy certain things, you can enjoy some. How many of you are going to enjoy some? Receive it in the name of Jesus. How many of you know that people succeed in mighty gifts? You are aware. You are aware that there are millionaires in mighty gifts. You are aware that there are rich people in mighty gifts. You are aware that some people are making it big. Why can't you make it? The door of all nations is open. So even if you are doing small job, profess that to yourself. That once I am in this town, me too, I go chop some. I go chop some. The chopping is not for some people. It's for all of us. Am I prophesying to some people? I don't think you like this point. I should close it. The door of all nations is open. I see you breaking through. There is somebody listening to me. Very soon, you will break through to the extent that people will envy you. People will not like you. But you don't care whether they like you or they don't like you. It's because the door of all nations is open. And I came to tell you, if you move from here to Italy, you must succeed. You go to Holland, you must succeed. You go to America, you must succeed. You come back home, you must succeed. Wherever you go, the door is open. I see that door open for you. And everywhere you turn, you must be a big person. God must make it for you. If you land in Togo, you must make it. You land in Burkina Faso, you must make it. Because the door of all nations is open. The blessings in any economy you find yourself, now you too, you'll be partaker. I said, now you'll be partaker. You understand? Any economy you enter into, the freedom there, you too, you must get some. Yes. That is why I see some of you, it won't be long, they will sign your papers for you. You must enjoy the freedom here. Their children go to hospital, your children must go. Their children enjoy something, your children must enjoy something. The door is open. Yes. If they don't understand, quote the Bible to them. Yes. And he died. Yes. And he rose. And by his death, the door to all nations. And you tell them, come and look at it. Once I am here, the door has opened for me. If it had not opened, I would not have crossed Kotoka International Airport. Once I crossed that airport and came here, the door here is open. How many of you can sense that the door is open? How many of you can sense that something big is about to land on you? Beginning from today, beginning from this very moment, you will not be ordinary again. I said, the door of all nations. When you are going, just be smiling.
Yes.
When you get home, if you get mud, I don't know whether they sell it. Get small and put it down. And look yourself in the mirror. Let me ask you why. You said, door of all nations. Nothing kings, hear us. Oh, you door of nothing kings, hear us. You must open for us. Oh, you door of Britain, Great Britain. Oh, you door of Great Britain. Listen to us. Jesus died, and by his death and resurrection, the door of all nations open. So door of Britain open to me. Open to me financially. Open to me socially. Open to me materially. Open to me any area open. Those of you in ministry must open. Ministry must not only be successful in Africa. The door must open here.
Yes.
Oh, you don't understand my preaching?
Yes.
It must open.
Yes.
Get ready to buy this place and break it.
Yes.
Break it and overbuild.
Yes.
Or leave this place and go and buy a bigger warehouse.
Yes.
Before the door must open.
Yes.
We must not just sit there. So you are small Africa church. You are just doing small. No. The door of all nations. Oh, you don't understand my preaching. How many of you can feel that door is opening? It's even opening into your pocket and bank account. How many of you can feel it? It's opening into your pocket and into your bank account. Ah, let the door of all nations open. I want you to stand up. I just feel like we must pray. I want you to stand up. You want to pray? Just on this one. You want to pray? Ah, yeah. I have one more point. I'll just give it to you. But before that, let